Hi everyone. Hope you all are safe, healthy and happy. Welcome back to my channel Sarah's Green Life. I'm at home and I thought it's going to be a chilled out day for me, but doesn't look like. I just received a call and I have to visit my adopter. So I had rescued a kitten called Nemo, who is now renamed as Miko. And he got adopted before I left for Pana. And I just got a call from the adopter that she's free today and if I would like to visit them, I can. I've been like wanting to do this. It's a working family, so they are only home on the weekends. So yeah, I have almost hour and a half to leave. It's an hour and a half's drive. So I'm going to get ready. And I thought, while I'm at it, why not take you all through how I get ready when I have around this much time, you know, for myself. So yeah, let's get started. Now, since I have hour and a half to get ready, I'm going to oil my hair. I've been doing this religiously and it has shown so much effect on my hair. When I was in Pana and I was doing safaris, my hair had gone for a toss, because obviously when you do safaris, they're in open jeep, there's so much breeze, dust and everything. So my hair had like literally gone messed up. Since I came back, every second or third day, whenever I want to wash my hair, I apply oil. And the one that I've been using is by the Tribe Concepts, is the 90 Day Miracle Oil. Oh my God, this product is life changer. And why I'm saying that is because earlier we used to make our own oil with all the herbs. So literally me and my mother used to go to Dadar market and fetch some fresh hibiscus flowers, rose flowers, neem leaves, and lots of dried herbs, and put them in the oil, let them soak, and then boil that oil and then drain it and everything. It was a tedious and a long process, but we used to do that. We used to take that pain thinking that, you know, in the market all the oils that you find are either they have artificial fragrance and, you know, unnecessarily added chemicals and all that. But when I found this and I smelled it, it is so close to how we used to make that oil. And that's when I realized the purity of it is like bang on. They are vegan, they are cruelty free. That is one reason I love this brand so much. Even when it comes to packaging, you can see that this is a glass bottle. Even their other stuff is packaged in steel and everything. And I've been using it, even my mother uses it, and now she's relieved that she doesn't have to go through that pain of making the oil. Now let's get to oiling the hair. I'm gonna take this oil in a glass bowl. It's got saffron in it, amla, bringraj, all those good for hair kind of stuff. I'm going to warm it up a bit. I'll be back. I've warmed it up. Now I'm going to start applying the oil in my scalp. So I just make partitions and I go on applying it on my scalp. I was so worried, like every time I used to be back from safaris and brush my hair, I used to lose a lot of hair, not because of like hair fall or anything, but they used to get entangled and, you know, it used to be a mess. So I used to break a lot of hair and I kind of panicked. but with this oiling and everything, I think hair is becoming better, it's getting smoother and things like those. Zero hair fall, like I rub so much and all, then nothing is falling. So that means it's like really working well. Okay, done. Now the thing with this oil is you can apply it and leave it overnight, or leave it for an hour for it to do its magic. I'll leave it for an hour. So I have an hour's time before I can take shower, so I'm going to quickly finish my work. And look who's giving me company. That's my latest rescue. After I came back from Pana, I got her. Her name is Lisa or Tara. I don't know, I'm confused. I really loved this name Tara that the caretaker in Panna had given to that little dog. So I'm thinking whether I should call her Lisa or Tara. Let me know in the comments below which one do you prefer. Lisa or Tara? Huh? Okay. Life of a cat and life of a human. I wish, you know, I could put them to work. Chalo, steam my and my dress. Huh. That's not how it is. Okay, I am done. So I've done all the other work that I had to finish before taking shower. Now I'm going to take bath and this is my latest find. It's again by the Tribe Concepts, called the Organic Hair Cleanser. Now, so I had been looking for shampoos and all to wash my hair that don't come in plastic bottles. And while I was going through the Tribe Concepts website, I found this. Again, it comes in a steel jar. It comes with a handy spoon. This is a very natural product with, you know, these herbs that are ground to fine powder. It's got that soap nut. It's got shikikai. All good stuff for hair. Take about 4 spoons of it and I mix it with water to make like a thick paste. I'm gonna quickly apply Tribe Concepts Kumkumadi Tailam. Let my hair air dry, but I want to show you all how they look after I blow dry. My hair is set. Now a little quick makeup and off to go. I'll just clip my hair so that we don't have any disturbance while we do the face. Okay. So now I'm going to start with my, because I'm going out in the day, I'm using a normal CC cream by Faces, which is a cruelty-free and vegan brand. It's got SPF 50 something, so it works well. Nothing, just quickly dab, not too much. So I don't understand when people say everyday makeup and they have high coverage foundations. I really like if my skin breathes through the day. I don't like to pile up too much foundation and everything on my face on regular basis, because that is a big no-no for my skin. As it is for work, I have to kind of use, you know, such these things. I'll add a little more on my neck. So this is a simple, minimalist kind of, you know, everyday makeup look that gets done in a jiffy. So I have applied that. Now I take a Miss Claire's two-way cake matte and poly powder basically to set it. Very little again, not too much, because I don't want my face to get oily during the day. So I set it very, very lightly with this. I use brushes like these because they kind of cover more area in lesser time. For my eyebrows, my favorite Tag Cosmetics eyebrow powder. I just fill in the gaps very gently. Like, I don't kind of use too much product. It's just little product on the brush, and that's it, gets done. So, okay, by the way, I forgot to mention, Miss Claire and these two brands are not 100% vegan, but they are cruelty free. But these products are vegan, so I use them. Kajal pencil again by Faces. So what I do is I kind of quickly put the kajal on the waterline. I also tight line it with the same kajal pencil. I take a smudging brush like this and I quickly go on my lash line to kind of give it that little smudged look. What this does is also protects my kajal from spreading. That is it. I'll quickly go over with the same kajal just to give it a little more intensity. And that is it. Kajal pencil by Faces, mascara by Faces, again cruelty free and vegan. I sometimes, you know, avoid applying anything on my skin and I just do my eyes, or if I have to just go, you know, not for any specific work or meeting. Okay, the last thing is a blush, which is basically a shimmery kind of a blush on with highlighter and everything. And it's by a brand called Sivana Colors. So it has, again, Sivana Colors is not a 100% vegan brand, but it is cruelty free and this product is vegan. So I use this. I take it on the brush very gently. I dust the extra and I go over my cheeks like so. So what I get is I get the color and I get that little highlighter finish. So after a couple of minutes, if you see, my entire cheeks will start to look as if they are glowing from within. So this is a good way of doing blush on. Last but not the least is the lipstick, again by Faces. So the nudest shade possible for my skin tone is this. That is it. If you want to know the shade, it is Go Chic Candy Floss something. See how quick that was. So I'm all set. This is how I get ready when I'm supposed to go out for any work. So I thought I'll share it with you all. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, and please do consider subscribing to the channel. I shall see you very soon in my next one. Until then, stay safe, feel good, and be blessed.